Okay, last time we talked about what a sequence is and what it means for it to converge. Let's do some examples of some sequences and get a better feel for what convergence means. So our first example is going to be the sequence 1/2, 3/4, 7/8, 15/16, and so on. So this is A1, this is A2, A3 is 7/8, A4 is 15/16. And we can figure out a formula for the nth one. It's 1 minus 2 to the minus n, 2 to the minus n. So this is 1 minus 2 to the, this is 1 minus a half, 1 minus a quarter, 1 minus an eighth, 1 minus a 16th. Now in this case, oh, and we also sometimes express the sequence. We put a brace and we put the list of, we might express the whole sequence like that, or we might put the formula in the middle. And that's our sequence. And it's obviously getting closer and closer and closer and closer and closer to 1. So this converges to 1. In fact, we could plot a graph of it. Now for a sequence, a graph is just a bunch of points. So we got 1/2, then 3/4, then 7/8, then 15/16, then 31/32, and so on. And it gets closer and closer and closer and closer to the value 1. So that's what this convergence looks like. Converges nicely. Next, let's look at an example of something that doesn't converge. Let's take the sequence 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 9, 2, 6, 5. In other words, we let an be the nth digit of pi. It's a perfectly good sequence. It's a list of numbers going on and on forever, but it doesn't converge. It doesn't settle down to any one number. It winds up bouncing around and bouncing around, and if you make a plot of it, well, you get 3, and then 1, and then 4, and then 1, and then 5, and then 9, and then 2, and then there's no pattern. There's no one line that it gets closer and closer and closer to. This diverges. Now you notice that diverges doesn't mean it necessarily gets big. Diverges means it doesn't settle down. In this case, it doesn't settle down because it bounces around like crazy. On the other hand, we could take a sequence 3, 3.1, 3.14, 3.141, 3.1415, etc. And this sequence, an, is pi to n minus 1 decimal places. So a1 is 3, a2 is pi to 1 decimal place, a3 is pi to 2 decimal places. And in general, an is going to be pi to n minus 1 decimal places. In this case, these numbers are getting closer and closer and closer and closer to something. They're getting closer and closer and closer to pi. And let me show you a few different notations. This is one notation to say the sequence converges to pi. Another notation would be the limit as n approaches infinity of a n equals pi. They mean the exact same thing. Right. Next example is an arithmetic series, a sequence. An arithmetic sequence is something like 2, 5, 8, 11, 14, etc. This is A1, this is A2, A3. Let me give you the definition. An arithmetic sequence is where the difference between any two numbers is constant. So the difference between the first two numbers, that's 3, is the same as the difference between the next two numbers, which is 3, which is the difference between the next two numbers, which is 3, and so on. Whenever you have an arithmetic sequence, you have a simple formula for it. It's going to be n times that standard difference plus some other constant. In this instance, it's 3n minus 1. Now, does this converge? Well, it can't settle down to a limit, because if an is really close to L, then an plus 1 is going to be really close to L plus D, in this case L plus 3. So arithmetic sequences never converge. They always diverge, unless D is 0. But that's cheating. That doesn't count. Okay, next example. 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13. This is defined by the formula that A1 is 1, A2 is 1, and from then on, each number is the sum of the previous two numbers. So 2 is 1 plus 1, 3 is 1 plus 2, 5 is 2 plus 3, 8 is 3 plus 5. This is called the Fibonacci sequence. Does it converge to anything? No, it gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. It certainly diverges. Okay. Let's finish off with a couple of examples that do converge. So let's look at the sequence 2, negative 1, 1 half, negative a quarter, 1 eighth, minus a 16th. This is an example of a geometric sequence. A geometric sequence is where the ratio of successive terms is a constant. And since it's a ratio of successive terms, we usually call it R. So we're interested in series where AN is some constant times R to the N. In this instance, we're taking AN is, well, that constant is minus 1 half to the N. And this is actually negative 4 times minus a half to the N, because the very first one is 2. So does this converge? Well, this certainly is getting smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. You go out farther and farther and farther and farther, and it approaches 0. In general, let's talk about a geometric series in general. If an is some constant times r to the n, then this converges to 0 if the ratio is smaller than 1 in magnitude. It can be minus a half like this, or it can be 2/3 or 9/10 or 1/2 or 0 or minus a third or plus 0.73. Any number that's less than 1, if you take more and more and more and more powers of it, is going to get smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller, and it's going to go to 0. What happens if R is equal to 1? That's a perfectly good series. The first term is C, the second term is C, the third term is C. It's a constant. So we say that converges to C. What happens if R is bigger than 1? If R is bigger than 1, the terms are getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. So this diverges. And finally, if R is negative 1, what happens? Well, you get C, then you get minus C, and then you get C, and then you get minus C, and then you get C, and then you get minus C, and it never settles down. It keeps bouncing between positive and negative. It doesn't converge. So it diverges if R is equal to negative 1. Now we're going to be comparing a lot of things to a geometric sequence. So you should definitely remember this behavior of geometric sequences. If the thing you're taking powers of is less than 1, it converges. If it's equal to 1, it converges. If it's equal to minus 1, it diverges. If in magnitude it's bigger than minus 1, it diverges.